the heavens or on the earth or in the sea. You must not bow down to them or worship them. For I, the Lord, your God, am a jealous God, who will not tolerate your affection for any other gods. I lay the sins of the parents upon their children. The entire family is affected, even children in the third and fourth generations of those who reject me. But I lavish unfailing love for 1,000 generations on those who love me and obey my commands. You must not misuse the name of the Lord your God. The Lord will not let you go unpunished if you misuse his name. Remember to observe the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. You have 6 days each week for your ordinary work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath day to rest dedicated to the Lord your God. On that day, no one in your household may do any work. This includes your sons and daughters, your male and female servants, your livestock, and your foreigners living among you. For in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth and the sea and everything in them, but on the seventh day he rested. That is why the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and set it apart as holy. Honor your father and mother, then you will have a long, full life in the land the Lord your God is giving you. You must not murder. You must not commit adultery. You must not steal. You must not testify falsely against your neighbor. You must not covet your neighbor's house. You must not covet your neighbor's wife, male or female servant, ox or donkey, or anything else that belongs to your neighbor. So if you guys see here, this is the Ten Commandments, just so we have a background information about what the Ten Commandments are. I don't want to take for granted that anybody understands and knows what the Ten Commandments are. I want you to understand, this is what the Jewish people were living under, and we still have Jewish people on this earth today, and they live under the law. These are their set of rules. This is basically how they achieve what we like to call righteousness, okay? If you turn back to Matthew's, our text, Matthew chapter 5, verse 20. Chapter 5, verse 20 in Matthew's, that Jesus is talking about the law. We all understand that. But he said this in this particular verse, in verse 20. He says, "For I say unto you, that except your righteousness shall exceed the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees, you shall in no case enter into the kingdom of heaven." Okay? If we understand here in this particular verse, He's basically talking about the Pharisees and the Sadducees, the rulers and the teachers of the law. And he's saying, if your righteousness, and if we all understand the word righteousness means to justify, cleanse, to clean ourselves. And they understand, and you know, just go back with me, if we don't really understand this concept as Christians, but they understood that if they followed the law, if they followed the law to the letter, meaning if they did everything that the law outlined to do, meaning that they did not steal, they did not kill, they didn't covet, they didn't work on Sunday, they were chilling on Sunday, they gave everybody the day off on Sunday, you know, like for real, you know, no work on Sunday, and everything like that. I'm waiting for no work on Sunday one day. But no, you know, they didn't do anything, you know, that was not subject to the law. They followed the law to the letter, to the T. And these were the people that were teaching the law and the people that were enforcing the law. If we understand that, Jesus is basically asking for the people. He says, you know what? I need you to do better than that. Already, we understand that the law was already a difficult thing to follow. He's talking to ordinary people here. He was saying to the people, you know what? I need you to be better than the teachers of the law. I need you. These teachers, they followed the law. They read the law. They taught the law. These people were on the law. You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
So if you understand the perspective that Jesus is basically giving them, he says, I need you to be better than the teachers of the law. From my conversation with God, and I had a hard time reading this, I was like, better than people that are teaching it. Like, they already follow it. They follow to the letter. I mean, they follow to a letter. They crucified Jesus over it.
Right.
They were fanatic about the law.
Right.
They knew the law inside and out. You couldn't stump them with a question about the law. It's almost like Jesus setting them up for failure when I look at it from first glance. It's like, okay, God, you're going to have to explain this one to me. Why are you asking them to be better than the people that teach the law? Why is it that you're asking them to go a step above? And then he revealed it to me. He said, you know what? Continue to read. Just keep looking, okay? So we're going to continue to read. Verse 21. Ye have heard that it was said by them of old time, thou shalt not kill, and whoever shall kill shall be in danger of judgment. But I say unto you, that whosoever is angry with his brother without a cause shall be in danger of the judgment. And whoever shall say to his brother, Raca, which means empty head, shall be in danger of the council. But whosoever shall say, thou fool, shall be in danger of hell. Therefore, no, I'll stop right there, amen. I want you guys just to see that, okay? Jesus is introducing something right here that this confounds probably the most wisest person about the law. He's basically asking you to go a step above. He introduces the concept of, you know what? Going above the law. You have the law, but I want you to do better than the law. I hope you guys are catching me. It's like, okay, all right, they already got the Ten Commandments. Now he's asking to go above it, to be better than that. Okay? So, if you understand what better means, it's like even you thinking about breaking the law, even you thinking about doing something contrary to the law, just a thought, just a passing thought, just run through your head. Jesus is basically calling that a sin. That is sin. It's like, man, is everybody, I hope I'm not, am I giving you hope yet? I probably not. But he's basically calling this concept sin. He's saying to you, you know what, we have the law, but you know what, I need you to be better. Like, you know, your teacher coming to you with a test. All right, you got 10 out of 10, you get 100, but I need you to get 110. There ain't no bonus questions or nothing like that, you know, extra credit I can get for this. But no, God, Jesus is asking you, no, be better than that. Do better than that. Do better than you're already doing right now, but then do better than that. All right? So it puts us in a position where we're basically the most unrighteous people in the world. That even a thought passing through our head. That even a passing, a fleeting thought, like, you know, a beautiful woman walks by, caught for a second, oh, you catch yourself that, sin.
Amen.
Your boss calls you into work on Sunday. You're trying to tell him, oh, this is my day of worship, and he's like, we got a deadline. Going to work, sin. You claim an extra kid on your tax returns. You're stealing from the government. Sin. You walk away, you know, the cashier at the McDonald's gave you an extra dollar, extra fry, or something like that. Sin. He's asking you to be better than that. And even the old prophet Isaiah, you don't have to turn here, but Isaiah 64:6, even Isaiah understood that what God was asking. He was living under the law as well. He didn't even hear what Jesus said. But he said, our righteousness is as filthy rags.
That's right.
If you understand that, your righteousness is as filthy rags. That means your ability to follow the law, your ability to be better than the law is filthy. That means you cannot.
Wow.
You cannot. Cannot. Have I given you any hope yet? Probably not. Probably not. Because everybody's sitting here probably like, so why are we sitting here? We're supposed to be in church getting to know about Jesus. And, you know, I thought I was going to heaven. You know, now you're telling me like everything I do is a sin.
Filthy.
Filthy. You're talking about dirt filthy, you know? So this represents a problem. Okay? And the problem is, why was the law introduced in the first place? If God knew that would be hard for us to keep the law. So we have a problem in our lives. We have a sin problem. Because even if we follow the law, even if we